What is up, everybody? It's the Wrestling Fan 410, back again with another video, and this is going to be my WWE No Way Out 2012 predictions video. And first off, I'd like to say this show does not look very good at all, and I'm going to be streaming it, but I'm not really looking forward to it. There's only three matches that I think have, like, potential, at least. And other than that, I hope it's a decent show, but I'm not looking for a show better than, like, Extreme Rules, or better than, not even better than Over the Limit. So, yeah, anyways, I just want to say, also, I watch Raw every week, but I don't watch SmackDown, so some of the buildings for these matches, I have no idea what's going on. So I may ask you, so if you guys can leave a comment down below if you guys watch SmackDown. Because honestly, I hate to say it, but WWE's been kind of boring now. So I hope they step it up, especially because they're putting an extra hour for Raw. So they really need to step up their game before that happens, because I found Raw decent on Monday. I found it kind of boring though, especially if I have to stay up till midnight, from 9 till midnight every week. Like, that's a lot of wrestling. And so yeah, okay then, so we're gonna start this off with the pre-show match, Brodus Clay versus David Otunga. I have no idea why this match is put on there, but I'm gonna go with Brodus Clay because he is just a little bit pissed off right now, so yeah, let's go with him. I really don't have an explanation for it. Who really cares? It's the YouTube pre-show match. Okay, and now the match that I believe will open up the show and will probably be match of the night. Christian versus Cody Rhodes for the Intercontinental Championship. They put on a pretty good match at Over the Limit, considering, you know, Cody Rhodes didn't get to really prepare for his match. But now, I think they could put on a hell of a match. I think it could be, like, over 10 minutes, if WWE gives some time. And yeah, this, I think Christian should retain the title. So yeah, I'm gonna go with Christian. But I believe both of them will be in the Money in the Bank ladder match. I don't believe either of them will win, but I believe both of them will be in it. Next match, Divas Championship match, Layla versus Beth Phoenix. I see Layla holding the title for one more time, for one more pay-per-view, maybe losing it to Beth Phoenix at Money in the Bank, and then have Karma return for Karma versus Beth Phoenix. I don't see Beth Phoenix getting another title run until Karma comes back, so that way they can face each other. So yeah, Layla is my pick for that match. Santino Marella versus Ricardo Rodriguez in a tuxedo match. I love Santino Marella. Ricardo's entertaining too, but why? Why would they put this match on the card? Anyways, I guess I'm going with Santino. What the hell were they thinking for this match? Yeah, Santino to win that match. Okay, Sheamus versus Dolph Ziggler for the World Heavyweight Championship. Obviously, Sheamus is going to win, because Ziggler is just there to fill in the shoes of Del Rio. Honestly, that's it. So, as much as I want Ziggler to win the title, it's not going to happen tomorrow night. So yeah, Sheamus to retain his title. CM Punk versus Kane versus Daniel Bryan triple threat match for the WWE Championship. For the WWE Championship. AJ on Raw, she stated, the best man will win. And everyone's given So basically, I'm not predicting who's going to win the match. I'm predicting who AJ is going to be with, because that's who's going to win. AJ will interfere, and she will be the decision maker for that match. So everyone's saying either CM Punk or Kane. I'm going to go with Daniel Bryan. I want to say that. AJ Styles, I mean, did I just say AJ Styles? I'm sorry about that, guys. AJ, I believe that she will be with Daniel Bryan. She will help him win the title and they'll get back together. But if that doesn't happen, I see CM Punk retaining. And then the main event, a match I think no one cares about at all. John Cena versus Big Show, their 1,500th feud they've ever had, and it. Not looking forward to it, but it's inside a steel cage. Oh, and if Big Show loses, John Laurinaitis will be fired. But if John Cena loses, he will be fired. Oh, I didn't know about that last part. But anyways, I was gonna say Big Show has to win, but they're not gonna get rid of John Laurinaitis. But I see John Cena winning this match, actually. But that's gonna, for whatever credibility Big Show did have as a heel, that's all going out the window once John Cena wins this match. That's the only problem. But I really don't care. I don't like Big Show as a heel. I think he did a good job in 2002. I think he did a great job when he first came in. But now it's just like, it's boring because when WWE needs a main eventer to step up, they change Big Show and they just shove him down our throats every time they need someone. It just doesn't make sense. So I'm taking John Cena for that match. And yeah, basically, that right there is no way out. It looks great. No, but honestly, I will watch the event and I'll give you my predictions. I mean, while you're watching my predictions, I'm sorry, I'm pretty tired right now. I'll give you my review on it. Hopefully, it's decent. And yeah, anyways, not looking forward to this. If I have to pick a show that I'm looking forward to, it's Destination X. Destination X is coming up soon. I'm actually enjoying TNA lately. I've been watching the last 4 weeks of Impact, and I sat through Slammiversary too, and Slammiversary was amazing. I forgot to put out a review on that, but I'll probably buy the DVD and then I'll give you a review. So yeah, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you guys enjoy No Way Out. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and peace.